is Kishore Chandiramani, and we are going to talk about non-identification today as a way of coping with stress. I want you to visualize your mind in terms of the internet. Now, on the internet, you have all sorts of things, good, bad, and ugly. And the same happens to the mind as well. There are all sorts of things that can come to the mind which may not belong to our true identity. And just as on the internet, if you Google a word, you get all sorts of names appearing on the drop-down menu. For example, if you put the word David, then you'll find all sorts of things appearing: David Beckham, David Cameron, David Blunkett, the David the murderer. But you don't want all of those. So you click on what you really want and leave the rest. Now the same thing happens to the mind as well. The mind is designed in such a way that it throws at you all the possibilities, even the remotest possibilities, to help you deal with the dangerous situation. But that doesn't mean that that is the reality. That is left to you to decide which one is the reality and cancel the rest of the thoughts. To give you an example, if I lose my mobile phone, then perhaps the first thought that comes to my mind is, has somebody stolen it? But then I say to myself, hold on, nobody has come into the house and I had the mobile phone and I haven't left the house, so it has to be in the house. So what I have done is I have cancelled my first thought that it is stolen. The next thought comes to my mind is, have I left it in the bedroom? Then I go to the bedroom and check, no, it's not in the bedroom. So I cancel that thought as well. And another thought comes to my mind, is it in the kitchen? And then I realize, yes, I left it in the kitchen. So I have cancelled two thoughts and then finally arrived at the reality. In the same way, whenever a thought comes to your mind, you have to say to yourself, just because this thought is there in my mind, I don't have to believe in it. I don't have to become its advocate. Or put it bluntly, I shouldn't become its slave. So here you are going to challenge each and every thought that comes to your mind and cancel certain thoughts, and that will help you reach the reality. This is non-identification. This concept of non-identification can be used differently as well. And for that, I would like you to imagine your mind in terms of two separate sections. One of the sections is thinking, judging, feeling, and reacting part of the mind, which is required when you are out and about, when you are active. But then there is another part of the mind that remains silent but is aware of everything. You can call it the inner consciousness. And this part of the mind doesn't make any judgments of good and bad. It doesn't react emotionally. It remains neutral. It's like a mirror which doesn't make any judgments about good and bad or right or wrong, but reflects everything. In a similar fashion, this inner consciousness remains neutral, doesn't make any judgments, has got no emotions that we normally experience in everyday life. And if you connect yourself to this second part of the consciousness, it helps with healing as well. So it is important to connect with the first part of the mind, that is thinking, judging, feeling, and reacting, in order to deal effectively with the external world. But when you want to deal with effectively with the inner world, you need to connect yourself to this second part of the mind, that is inner consciousness. We all connect with this consciousness at different times without our realization. In deep sleep, when we are not dreaming, we are connected to this inner consciousness. And this helps us undo the stress. During the daytime as well, there are moments when we stay connected with this consciousness. And those are the moments when we are in the moment, present, not thinking anything in particular, have no strong emotions, at the same time enjoying inner peace. And we are with the perception, we are aware, but not reacting emotionally. So those are the moments perhaps we are connected to that inner consciousness. Thank you.